folks. Happy Halloween! Sorry I didn't do a video last week. I have a good excuse. We were moving. Not moving, whole house moving, but swapping offices. If you watched a lot of my videos, you've probably figured out that I work from home. I run a business from my home. We didn't used to do that. We used to rent office space for years and years. We had full office space, you know, lots of room for all of our equipment and file cabinets and everything. Well, we finally realized it doesn't make sense to do that. Our clients aren't local. I mean, I have one or two local clients, but that's it. Everybody else is really out of state. I mean, we're talking New York or Texas or California, and I'm in Florida. So there wasn't really a big need for an office space, but we, you know, a regular office space, like in an office building. But I did need, if I was going to bring it into the house, I needed a house big enough to house all of our file cabinets and equipment and computers and desks and all the stuff, you know, our whole phone system, everything. And I wanted it to be separate from the living part of the house, because I didn't want people to come into my living room, go through my kitchen, you know, to get to my office. I didn't want that. This house was perfect for running a business. The prior owner converted a carport into one of the bedrooms, and he gave it a second exterior entrance off of the courtyard. So right opposite the house's front door is a door into this bedroom. So that became the entrance to our office. And that space, I refer to that as the front office. Then off of that is a mud room that we used for our fax machine, our copier, miscellaneous supplies. And then off of that room was a second bedroom, which I'll call the back office. And those were the three spaces we've been using for our business. On top of that, we have stuff in the sheds because we have a lot of stuff. But anyway, over the years, like I said, we've been here, I think, about 7 years. We have swapped offices a few times. I started in the front office. After the after a couple of years, I decided it would be better to put Noferblatz there because he had more file cabinets. He had the mailing equipment and the huge work table that they have to sit on. It made sense for him to have the front office because it's bigger. And I took the back office, and I loved it in the back office until the great flood happened. And if you watch that video, you know the nightmare that that was. I had an inch of water all over my floor in this back office. So after we had to, of course, empty this room anyway to remove the carpet that was totally destroyed, we decided, let's swap offices again. Put me back into the front office, and he came back to the back office. Well, recently I decided, you know what? I want to come back to the back office and put him back in the front. And I had a variety of reasons for that. For one, I have a better view out front from this back office. I can see when anyone's approaching. It doesn't happen very often, but I can. But more important than that, Noferblatz has wanted a futon in his office since he's had an office. On the weekends, he hangs out in his office a lot on the weekends, and he likes to take a nap, and he won't get up and go all the way to the bedroom to take a nap. I've caught him sleeping in his chair more times than I can count. So he wanted a futon where he could actually stretch out and be comfortable and take a nap. The only way we were going to pull that off, though, is A, move him up to the front office, and B, do some more rearranging. He has a bank of 6 file cabinets that are his domain, basically. It's client files that have invoices and statements and correspondence, okay? And imagine how much room 6 4-drawer file cabinets take up. Since we got rid of we used to have a big, huge, massive copier. We got rid of that, I guess, almost a year ago now. And we just have one of those all-in-ones. So I said, let's bring the all-in-one into my office and take those 6 file cabinets and set them up in the mudroom. That clears enough floor space for him to have his futon. So he liked that idea. And that's how we spent last weekend. So I have a really good reason for not doing a video, because it took the entire weekend to do this move. And it really still isn't done. I mean, the main stuff is moved. But if you were to see the rest of my office, you'd see that I don't have any of my books really in here yet. My bookshelves that are over here behind where the camera is are empty. And I've got stuff still in boxes. I haven't figured out where I'm going to put things. So I'm still not done. I've got to finish all that. Noferblatz's office is more done than mine. We still have to go get him the futon, but he still has to come up with places to put a few things and finish figuring out how he wants to reorganize his desk. If you can look behind me, You'll see I don't have my hutch anymore. I decided to get rid of the hutch off the back of my desk because it wasn't that beneficial and I need that space for other things. And I'm still trying to figure out how I'm going to set everything up. But at least the big stuff is moved. And that was more than just moving stuff. I mean, we had to have put everything up on platforms in case we have another flood. We were moving, like I said, those 6 file cabinets into the mudroom. And if we have one of these floods from the street, then the mudroom is where it goes first. And so he built platforms. The file cabinets are 3 and 3 on the opposite sides of the room. So I had to build 2 platforms to raise those file cabinets off the floor, about, you know, roughly 3.5 inches. And then we had to make sure we had platforms for the stuff going back into my office, because this room is the second room that gets flooded. It usually doesn't go beyond these 2 rooms. I have 3 legal size 4-drawer file cabinets. So they had to go up onto a platform. And then behind me, you can see I have a lateral and 2 2-drawer file cabinets. They're up on platforms. My desk was already up on platforms because sometimes I have to stand for my back. And I had to make sure my computers were off the floor. So it was a very long weekend. And hopefully by this weekend, I'll have maybe gotten my office. No, I won't be finished show this weekend because Noferblatz is going to build me a shelf to replace my hutch. And that may hopefully happen this weekend, and I'll help them with that. So anyways, at some point, my office will finally be done being reorganized. But I am functioning. I got my computer up and running, of course, because I have to be running our business. And so by last Monday, it had to be up and running. Anyway, that's my excuse. I apologize for not doing a video last week. I will try my best to do one this weekend. And I guess that's it for now. You're up to date. I think Noferblatz is going to try and get some videos recorded this week too, because I know it's been a while since he's posted one as well. Anyway, that's all for now. Come back and see me.
See ya.